We don't stress. I'm 38 till it free your chest. And PP on the PO's desk. I'm JC in a blowout press. Relate me to your blowout's best. Can you hate me or remote your death? I'm HD causing photo theft. My AC and he freeze. Gotta hold your breath. I'm 8 feet when I hold this tech. Protect me from the local threats. My ID say my eye don't rest. My IV qualified T-Rex society. Kept my IQ vexed. Denying me from my Ivy school. Applying me to the street I slept. I quietly had the holiest tool. Reminding me of the block I rep. The turf I step. The church and the earth I bless. The first I guess the alert was the murk I chef. That hurts to flirt with perks of a kill. Confess disperse the worst. The first 48 address the search and loss of verse of the birth. I nest the odd the curse of opposing sense. The good, the flaws, the pain to reverse what's left.
Rap music and race. The relationship between rap music and race is that rap music is a direct form of African-American culture in the United States. Rap music is a style of art that encapsulates many aspects of race, religion, political affiliation, and home life that represent a large portion of our society. In addition to enjoying rap as an expressionist art, we can identify and help to solve several social justice and institutional issues that our country has through analyzing rap music in all varieties. Rap music can provide information about the preferential option for the poor, as well as from heavy situational exposure in its lyrics and music videos. As rap has developed from a historical standpoint, it has gone from a method of storytelling to a combination of instruments within a beat supporting lyrics. Originating as hip-hop rap in New York City, on the East Coast, other parts of the country, specifically the West Coast, began experiencing growing popularity and competition for innovative rap glory. Rap is an extremely significant part of the African-American musical culture and has many positive attributes to social studies and ethics that are often overlooked. Ethical analysis. The ethical system of utilitarianism is the belief in doing whatever it takes to maximize happiness and decrease pain. The principle of utility can be related to rap culture, because young aspiring rappers can see the most successful persons as a representation of happiness and an escape from the harsh conditions of poverty in America. Similarly, preference utilitarianism converts to rappers having limited opportunities and preferences. The money and fame at the end of the road justifies the rapper lifestyle that sometimes includes crime and disregard for academic or athletic performance. Writing music can take children and adults alike out of the reality of their situations and allow them to create art in the most natural way possible. So in order to begin the process of understanding our society as a whole, rap music needs to be analyzed rather than rejected. Instead of labeling the form of expressionism as evil or poisonous, people should take care to learn about the environment that directly contributes to some of the negative concepts found in modern-day rap music. Christian ethics. All right. Swarp Roman. Rap about rap. Rap about race and rap. Race, rap, Christian ethics. Let's get it. Gotta express my feelings through poetry. Dodging all the gangs of 12 trying to get a hold of me. There's quite a few principal beliefs that lead to the oppression and the general sense of bigotry. I must have missed every decent opportunity. Not for skipping class, but for the skin color people see. That's racism. Yeah. Race is linked to rap, just like thumbs to a snap. Like a legend on a map, like your bullets in a strap. In many ways, it's guidance and direction. Our savior and protection, the largest man-made form of urban black expression. So selling drugs and dropping out, it seems as a social norm. But rap music ain't poison, it's an articulate art form. Infiltrate your senses, leave you paralyzed like chloroform. Lyrics about why brothers rarely see the insides of a college dorm. That's fucked up. Intellects dodge our problems in whichever way. They trying to analyze with blurry vision, window rainy day. Peer into the racial institutions, leaving generations in poverty. Spillin' the beat, got me uttering words flawlessly. With utilitarian minds, there ain't nothing gonna be stopping me. Wait for the beat to drop again. So the rap game's my monogamy. The streets is where I'm meant to be, and now I'm public enemy. But an issue as of late that's been tolling on me mentally is the police. Tax collecting with black lives as the fee. Please get off of me, Eric Garner, I can't breathe. Yeah, this life is cheap, but it ain't free. And seemingly, the ghetto symphony has granted me a full reprieve. The music is the message of the people. The music is the holy bells ringing at the steeple. And rap gives a voice to some who don't have one at all. And rap is the loudspeaker sounding through the hall. The culture's bringing us back to Nas and Biggie Small. The 1990s revolutionary music hall. Yeah. And it led to complex rhymes and groups like the Wu-Tang. Yeah, the rap gang done changed, went through a big bang. The times are changing, the game is changing, but one thing's consistent, the lack of white privilege. In the rap game. In the rap game. Yeah, that's where it is. So analytically, the principle of utility is helping young black rappers escape the reality. Who really cares? As long as the ends justify the means. And why not take a chance on a dream? With feasibility to take you and moms out of poverty.